Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today I'm going to discuss the security of SMS-based two-factor authentication. If you've been watching my videos, you know that I highly recommend two-factor authentication. While I personally think there's still some value in passwords as long as you implement password security best practices, I know that no token of authentication is infallible. Whether it be a hardware token, a password, or even a biometric, there have been ways where attackers can gain access to those tokens and break into your accounts. And that's why the best way to increase the security of authentication is by combining tokens together in what we call multi-factor authentication. That way an attacker has to find or steal multiple tokens in order to log in as you. Now, one of the forms of two-factor authentication I've recommended in the past is something called SMS-based authentication. And this is where, besides just logging onto a site with your username and password, the site will send your cellular phone a text message that contains a temporary one-time password, which you also have to enter in to gain access to your account. Now, I didn't recommend SMS-based two-factor authentication because it's the most secure option out there. In fact, it isn't. But I did recommend it because it's the easiest to consume for the average user. One of the biggest obstacles to multi-factor authentication is previous solutions were very complex and costly. They required organizations to set up proprietary servers and sometimes use costly hardware tokens, which really put them out of the realm of possibility for the average consumer. Meanwhile, almost every person in the world has a cellular phone. Even if they don't have a smartphone, they at least have a cellular phone that can receive text messages. So SMS-based two-factor authentication is a frictionless option that almost everyone in the world can consume. So why am I talking about this? Well, over the week, a number of stories came out essentially saying that SMS-based two-factor authentication is too insecure and needs to be replaced. And these are all based on an update from a U.S. government organization called NIST, or the National Institute of Standards and Technology. Among other things, NIST is who recommends security best practices for the U.S. government. In one of their documents where they talk about multi-factor authentication, they specifically call out SMS two-factor authentication as having some security weaknesses, and they say that it should be depreciated. That doesn't mean they're banning it outright yet, but by depreciating it, they suggest that they might ban it in the future. So what are the weaknesses in SMS-based authentication? Well, ultimately, they come down to interception problems and redirection problems. When you send a text message, it can be encrypted. There are cellular standards to do just that. But researchers have found weaknesses in these standards, so they can crack your text messages. Worse yet, a lot of cellular carriers don't even bother encrypting text messages, which all means that if a bad guy can intercept your text message, they have that one-time password that you're using. However, as you can imagine, it is somewhat difficult to actually intercept cellular communications. This is pretty proprietary communication happening on a closed network. However, other researchers have recently found vulnerabilities in other carrier protocols like SS7, which ultimately means that if they have the IME number of a cellular phone, they can actually intercept all that user's text messages. So there are ways, sophisticated ways, that bad guys can actually intercept text messages, which means they can actually get these one-time passwords. The second issue is redirection. There has been documented cases where attackers have called up vendors using a two-factor authentication solution, and using social engineering have been able to convince those vendors to actually use a different cell phone, meaning the one-time password actually doesn't even go to your own phone, it goes to the attacker's phone directly. And besides that, there's also been cases where specific mobile malware was designed to capture your text messages in hopes of catching that one-time password. Long story short, all of these are reasons why NIST doesn't think that SMS-based two-factor authentication is the most secure option out there. Now, there are other options out there. In fact, a very popular one right now is using push notification systems on smartphones. Both iOS and Google devices offer this push notification component where vendors can make an encrypted channel directly to your phone to send notifications. And this becomes a very secure mechanism to send one-time passwords directly to your phone. In any case, NIST is right that SMS-based authentication is not the most secure option out there. If you have the choice, you should consider more secure options like that push technology I just mentioned. Now, all that said, a lot of the headlines seem to suggest that SMS-based authentication has no value and should go away. And this is where I really kind of disagree. While SMS authentication has some obvious weaknesses, it is still pretty hard to crack. You know, being able to man in the middle cellular network traffic and catch that one text message you're looking for is not not a trivial task. It's something that nation-state threat actors can certainly do, but it's still kind of difficult for the average criminal to do. Now, if I had the choice of no two-factor authentication at all and SMS-based authentication, I would still pick SMS-based authentication all the time. So here are my takeaways. First of all, if a system ever offers you two-factor authentication, always use it. Even if the particular system uses a weaker form of a token, any combination of multiple tokens will always increase the security of your account. Second, if a two-factor system offers multiple choices for your second factor of authentication, maybe they offer text-based authentication, but they also offer a mobile app that has push notification. You now know that there's some weaknesses with SMS-based authentication, so use the mobile app. It's technically more secure. Finally, just because NIST is depreciating SMS-based authentication, don't avoid it. If you get to a system like Twitter where their only option is SMS-based two-factor authentication, you should still use it. There's still a lot of value to having that second token. While it is technically possible for a very sophisticated actor to intercept your text message or maybe redirect your phone call, they would still need your password. So putting these tokens together always has additional value. Anyways, I just thought it was an interesting story, but I think you should still use two-factor authentication no matter what form it takes. That's all for today's story. Thank you for watching.